Spores are gross, but they'll give me some cover. The Purge left these machines behind. I could sneak by them, deal with a big one. Spores will provide cover for a while if I shoot that. Poseidon is through there. But where did that machine go?
Aloy! It's a miracle!
Come on, come on.
Hey, was this you? Did you lower the waters?
Yeah, but there's a new problem. That thing's in our way.
Scrappy band of adventurers beheld the beast. They knew what they had to do. Are you crazy?
Hush now. She saved our Delph.
Okay, then. Stay up here and start firing when I engage.
Get to that overhang.
Come on, gentlemen, get a move on. Everyone okay?
Those fracas never hurt anyone. And so, the great adventurer...
You guys all right?
More than all right. We did it! all the embers we could ever want, and it's all thanks to you.
Very, heartwarming. But maybe we can just, you know, grab what we came here for and get out before any more of those things decide to show up.
Now, now, Shard Counter. Nothing wrong with a little reveling. Though we should probably let our flame-haired friend get going. I believe she has business down here, does she not?
Right, of course. You need any help?
I can handle it from here.
Very well. Well, we'll start taking some of the embers upstairs. Holler if you need us.
Thanks. Poseidon should be somewhere beyond this door. Time to bring it home. What'd I give for a cool breeze? Okay, Poseidon should be hiding in some kind of processor. I need to find a console to gain access to it. There, I should be able to use that console. I'm here to bring you home, Poseidon. To Gaia.
Yes. Mother. All waters lead back to her.
Elizabeth Sobek. Alpha Prime.
Master override activated. Restoring Poseidon's subordinate function to original code.
Gotta bring this back to Gaia.
System reboot initiated.
Looks like taking Poseidon triggered a restart of the city's power system. Worland and crew must have headed back up top. With all the embers they could carry, I bet.
Thank you.
fresh of air. An elevator. Morland must have built this before the place flooded. It still work. Be nice not to have to climb back up.
Whatever she did, it must have powered up the whole city.
Is that legal?
What's going on out there?
The show my old gramps always wanted.
There's another.
His dream realized. His old gramps' legacy ensured. Our hero beheld the sea of desert lights and wept at his good fortune.
When I saw the embers as a child, I never dreamed they could be like this. Thank you, Aloy. Well, did you find what you were looking for?
I did. And now I have to move on.
Oh. Come back when you can. I got big plans for this place.
I thought you wanted to put on shows with the embers back in the claim.
Oh, no. This is the show. Oh, can you imagine? Folks from all over the land coming to take it all in. Plus some food and a nice place to stay.
Not to mention a variety of entertainment venues.
Don't forget. Games of chance. Plenty of shards to be had there for certain.
A new dream, huh? I hope you make it happen. Goodbye, gentlemen.
This delve was a story for the ages. All thanks to you.
If Morland and crew's gonna stay, maybe I should come back and check on them later. For now, I need to get Poseidon back to Gaia. But I might want to find that Oseram camp first. See if Talana made it. And with my new diving mask, I should be able to swim as deep as I want to. Once I find a place with more water. That helmet looks damaged. I should take a closer look. This looks like us from here. What are they doing here? Reboot. So an override might fix the tonic. But how do I get up to it? Dead Oseram. Machines from the look of it. This thing shoots anchors? They were trying to take down that tall neck. The machines must have caught them in the act. I wish there was a way to climb up and inspect the damage. Unless I take the tall neck down myself, try to repair it on the ground. Won't be pretty, but at least it'll get fixed. Sounds like trouble. And I need more breakers. I know the Oseram set up other ballistas in the area. I just gotta use them. There's probably other anchors set up in the area. I need to find them. Use them to take down that Talmec. more dead Osram. Looks like they took a machine down with them. Another ballista. And it's got one of the anchors I need. One more should weigh it down enough. I need to hurry. Hello to you too! It's down! That weapon still has an anchor. Let's use it. Sorry about this, big guy. Hopefully that's the last of those machines. Now let's get the big guy fixed. I'm gonna fill up while I can.
I see you, champion. Sit, please.
Good paint for a good soldier.
I spotted a group of Osram salvagers wandering the edge of the desert, near the southwestern border. I'd report it, but I don't think they'll last long. If the machines down there don't get them, the storms will.
Oh, that's kind of you. Sounds like those Osram could use a hand. I'll keep an eye out for them if I'm down there.
Thank you. Well, they didn't have two left feet, like I do.
I could teach you.
Don't tempt me.
Find a forge. Find an inn. And leave me alone.
Welcome back, Aloy. I see you have recovered Poseidon.
Drone's reconnected now.
Can you come downstairs? Beta has something you need to hear.
Okay. I'll be right down.
Aloy, I have managed to unlock additional rooms within the facility.
Hi, Gaia.
Hello, Aloy.
Were you able to make use of Poseidon?
Yes. Many rivers, streams, and lakes associated with the regional watershed have been detoxified. As a result, red algae growth levels have seen a marked decline. According to my data, however, it appears a localized occurrence of red algae continues to persist near the coast.
Maybe I'll look into it when I can. What can you tell me about Demeter?
Demeter sows, fertilizes, and tends to plant life.
So once I bring it back, all the blight out there will start to get better.
While permanent restoration requires the abilities of Hephaestus, I may be able to improve conditions in the region for a while. However, a word of warning. Like Aether and Poseidon, Demeter's response to my query was highly irregular. Alone and frightened, it may have taken measures to assure its security.
Okay, I'll keep my guard up. You mentioned that the superstorms have subsided. Is that Aether at work?
Yes. Thanks to Aether's capabilities, weather patterns in the local region should mostly stabilize for the time being.
Well, that's a relief. Be nice not to have to fight my way through a storm anymore.
I will continue to stabilize the atmosphere for as long as I can.
You said Hephaestus isn't located in just one place.
Correct. Unlike the other subordinate functions, which are confined to discrete physical processors, Hephaestus is distributed throughout the global network that connects the planet's cauldrons.
So when the time comes to subdue it, how do we make that happen?
I do not know. While you are retrieving the last subordinate function, Beta and I will attempt to find a solution.
See you later, Gaia.
Until next time, Aloy.
Anybody seen one of my machine strike pieces around?
Why don't you check the cache? Maybe you left it there when you dropped off all that ale.
Oh. Hope it didn't get stained.
Where have I seen this before?
Huh. The door is unlocked now.
Isaac, Daddy sure does love his little big man.
She found that recording from the data on your focus. She's been watching it a lot. I think it helps calm her.
You know, I used to watch this a lot too. Whenever I wanted to take my mind off things.
Daddy sure does love his little big.
But there's something you need to tell me?
While you were gone, I came down here to check on her. Then we started talking. Right, Beta? She's been thinking about how to capture Hephaestus, you know, studying the data Gaia gave her. But we started talking about some other stuff. You know, just getting to know each other, right? And then she told me that one of the Zeniths might be different from the others.
Tilda. You saw her at the Hades Proving Lab.
Go on.
On the way to Earth. The Zeniths never showed their faces. My servitor caretaker referred to them as my benefactors, and promised I'd meet them someday, when I had learned enough. And then, one day, a data channel opened in my training interface. In it, Tilda was waiting for me, in a virtual replica of a house on a cliff. Overlooking the ocean. It was beautiful. She showed me paintings, books, media files. We met there in secret many times. But a few months later, it stopped.
Can you tell us why, Beta?
I found some data about Tilda at the Hades Proving Lab. I think she was a liaison between Far Zenith and Zero Dawn. She knew Elizabeth Sobeck, that's for sure.
Maybe that's why she reached out to you?
What else can you tell us about Tilda? She liked to talk about her paintings. What about herself? Did she ever talk about her life on Earth, how she joined the Zeniths, something like that? She never said much about herself, and she hated it when I asked too many questions. But I think, back on Earth, she was an expert programmer, given that she built a data channel the other Zeniths couldn't detect. Is there anything else about her that we might be able to use to our advantage? She was the first real person who ever bothered to speak to me. I wasn't really assessing her for strengths and weaknesses. So Tilda set up a secret virtual space where she could talk to you, a house on a cliff. Then later, she cut you off. but other than the fact that Tilda knew Elizabeth, you don't know why she did those things?
I don't, okay? I thought of every possible reason that would make her leave, but whatever I did wrong, I don't know what it is. When I finally met the others, she ignored me. Acted like the data channel never existed. None of this even matters. Tilda's the same as the others. It won't help us defeat them.
Okay. Let's leave it at that, then.
What's wrong?
I'm trying, Varl. But she is tough to take. I'm out there in the wilds, risking my life every day, and all she can do is hide in there and tell us how hopeless it all is. I'm sorry, she's had a rough time, but she is really not helping right now.
You always seem to be on top of everything, so I sometimes forget about what you've been through. I mean, it wasn't that long ago you were so banged up you couldn't even walk. About that. When I pulled you out of the water back near the Proving Lab, you were muttering Rost's name. You never talk about him, but he raised you, trained you. You must miss him a lot.
Of course I do, but I don't have time to think about that now. I need to get back out there.
Okay, I'll keep working with Beta. Gaia says she knows a lot about Zero Dawn. And maybe she just needs some time to adjust, and then she can help us with Hephaestus.
Sure. But I won't hold my breath.